percentage might be, because there's a lot of Taiwanese people, a lot of Taiwanese American people, and a very, very proud Taiwanese American. And I was trying to think about what sets us apart as Taiwanese Americans. We'd love to ask you all, like, what do you think the defining attributes are of being Taiwanese or Taiwanese American? Like, what defines us as a people? The doors open. Take the hard road. Hard work, I like it. First impression. Top to that. What else? You open. Passionate. That's beautiful.
If you open.
Bubble tea. Why not? So, my parents, including my lovely mother, is here with us tonight, moved back to Taiwan. And so I went back to visit them about the Taiwanese Tourism Association. Like, what is the tagline for Taiwan?
First impression.
Heart of Asia. And what was it before that? Touch your heart. Remember that?
Yes.
You go and it'd be just like pop star. So my wife, well, my girlfriend and I, now my wife, and I went back to visit Taiwan. We'd look at this and we would be like oh, isn't that cute? But I have to say that I think it's central to Taiwanese culture that we actually do help out in the house. She's in the very warm. You visit Taiwan. How many of you feel more welcome in Taiwan? She's closing up. Come to visit me. She said that she's lonely. Said it's hard to open up. As like anyone to Taiwan, and you're like, yeah, they got it here. It's a good Taiwan. It's very, very warm. And so I think the Heart of Asia, Touch Your Heart, is actually a great app for us. But I think we're a very warm, caring people. Second thing, which you guys are too humble to say, we are very, very smart. Where Taiwanese Americans have the highest education like any group in the country. How many of you know that? You it's true, you can look it up. The highest education attained in any group in the country. And then the third thing I think sets us apart is that we're very proud of being Taiwanese American. I'm going to share a story. I've got a friend of mine whose cell phone cover is a subway map of Taipei. You know? And that's a little weird, but actually maybe it's be like, oh, that's pretty cool, I should try and get one of those. Because we were very, very proud of being Taiwanese. We were very caring, smart, and proud of your people. And I think those things actually lend themselves very much to the theme of today, which is on heritage and response, and it is in a responsible way. So I grew up in Westchester, New York. I'm from Westchester. I'm from Westchester. My mom, my dad, very educated, said, you know, we should get education. So I went to college, law school, and then was a lawyer for about 5 months. Like an Asian lawyer. So I'm not as good a lawyer as you are, but I'm sure I did more than 5 months. So I left after 5 months to start a company, the first .com bubble. I was 25 years old. How many of you have started a business? That is the theme of today. Oh my gosh. So keep your hand up. Yeah, starting a business or organization is very, very hard. And I found that out firsthand when I started my first company in my mid-20s. And the way I started this company was I was like a bright 20-something year old. I made a PowerPoint deck and I started going around asking investors for money. Now, raise your hand if you've ever asked investors for money. Yeah, so you know how much fun that is. So when we go around. And my mom remembers this, where she was like, oh my gosh, he quit his lawyer job, he's doing what? So I went around with this PowerPoint deck, and then eventually someone decided to write my company a check, and then another check, and raised about $250,000. And that felt like a lot of money at the time for a 25-year-old starting a business. But that business did not work out at all. The dot-com bubble burst. No one cared about my little dot-com. StarGiving.com was actually a very wholesome company. It raised money for celebrity-affiliated nonprofits. It was like a very beautiful, wholesome idea. But when the dot-com bubble burst, like, the tide washed my company away, along with every other little dot-com in New York. And so then, I was 26, I just lost investments of $250,000. I still owed $100,000 in law school loans, and actually disappeared when I met my lawyer though. I used to jokingly call my school loan my mistress, because I was like writing a check to like a random family in another town. And like, I hope they're enjoying themselves over in like town, South Bend or whatever. So I was 26, 27, a failed entrepreneur, lost investors $100,000, and it was a tough time, but I resolved that I wanted to get better at being an entrepreneur because I just enjoyed Start up, and I'd highly recommend it because it's a beautiful film about how people try to find their way and start businesses, which again, is a So as part of Venture for America, I started receiving all these awards. I kind of received a couple awards from the Obama White House. And I'll tell you guys a story about the Obama White House visit. So I was named a presidential ambassador for the Obama And so, of course, being a good Taiwanese man, I brought my wife. And so I come with my wife, and I'm the only person who brought my spouse to this thing. It's like me, my wife, and it's like, you know, David Jobs, Charles Hammond, and his staff are around here, and like, you're kind of his staff. Like, everyone's a staffer, except for me. I was like, what's wrong with these people? We're walking from one White House room to the next, and President Obama's like right here in front of me. And Evelyn's here, so I'm like, yeah, let's just do this. Like, go up to President Obama, and I take the president. And he turns around and is like, nice to meet you. And like, puts on the high heels. So this story made my in-laws very happy for quite some time.
Next. very much. First of all, I would like to thank for me to invite me here and to Andrew to very generously share his platform with me. I'm Pei, 中文叫苏佩芬. I was born in Taiwan, but I have lived in the UK in the last 22 years. So I've been very honored to come to New York to share you know, my experience with you as an entrepreneur. I was an entrepreneur. I'm a social entrepreneur. I can see as a non-profit. And to also, I'm a receiver from entrepreneurship of a CSR from enterprise. So I think hopefully my multiple roles will give me some different experience I did along my journey. I've been sharing this with you
First impression, you
open. Last year was my 25 years in the working for non-profit. And I have to say it's a very tough journey. And you know, not many people survive after 25 years. And I hope I've been around 20 years to carry out to work.
First impression, you open.
In 2004, I was the first finalist of Best Charity Profession for the UK.
We believe that the way to tackle issues of extreme animal cruelty, human suffering, and the large scale destruction of the environment is not by firefighting the individual problems, but by changing the people through education. Our efforts are concentrated into three pillars: school education, consumer education, and education. In Chinese schools, we run our Empowering for Life program that reached more than 36,000 students with an empowerment teachers to inform and educate our compassion, empathy, and our impact on the animals and our planet. In educating consumers, we concentrate on promoting a compassionate lifestyle. Our annual fur-free fashion event in China is a world first, influencing millions of fashion shoppers across the globe and gaining momentum and recognition each successive year. We offer professional education to key stakeholders like individuals thinking about animals and our planet. That's why we train vets in order to improve welfare standards of animal treatment. To date, we've trained almost 800 vets in China. Training the trainers is a key feature of our training projects. But as always, there's more to be done. More children to be educated, more vets to train, more suffering to be brought to an end. We desperately need your support to continue making a difference. Visit appasia.org to learn more. Become a supporter and to donate. Together, we can change things for the better.
We started small. We're still relatively small.
Hi, it's Carl.
But as chili, we're very powerful. You can taste the flavor. And sometimes the taste of flavor stays a long time. So it's okay to start it as small. And we might deliberately choose to be small because sometimes after the, you know, in the non-profit sector for a long time, big, not always that efficient as well. Next one. We are talking about we receive the awards, the charity from, you know, in the China or also outside of China as well. closer to friends. If you open your eyes, I'm guiding myself. I'm crash my chariot, get ya. The door's open. Take the high road and hop in. First impression, you open. We should be closer to friends. If you open, engaging is on my agenda.Request my chariot, get ya. The door's open. Take the high road and hop in. First impression,
you open.
We should be close friends.
If you open,
engaging is on my agenda. Request my chariot, get ya. The door's open. Take the high road and hop in.First impression,
you
open.
We should be close
friends. If you open, engaging is on my agenda. Request my chariot, get ya. The door's open. Take the high road and hop in.
Monarch butterflies, you should open up. I'm trying to put your heart together,
really
better broken up. Going up
the
smoke, smoking up. Make sure the children in the house, she's in
the
appropriate young. The way she's approaching us, I disassociate. Exfoliate, then renegotiate. She's closing up, come to visit me. She say that she's the loneliest, since it's time to open up.
Open
you up like a
park,
open up.
Tell you how far, park,
let your emotions
walk
all over. Open up. The door's open. Take the high road and hop in. First impression, you open. We should be close friends. If you open, engaging is on my agenda. Request my chariot, get ya. The door's open. Take the high road and hop in. First impression, you open. We should be close friends.If you open, engaging is on my agenda. Request my chariot, get ya. The door's open. Take the high road and hop in.
up. I'm trying to put your heart together, found it broken up. Going up smoke, smoking up. Make sure the children in the house is in the proper yuck. The way she's approaching us, I disassociate. Exfoliate, the renegotiate. She's closing up. Come to visit me, she say that she the lonely yuck. Said it's hard to open up.
Open you up like a pokeball. Open up.
And I want you to tell you what I'm talking about. Let your emotions fall. And I do believe CFL education is where culture raises our humanity. And this is not only what I'm saying. I'm working with the University of Oxford. This is a medical professor. And she is working with girls about why CFL is important because let your emotions fall. Society will want to be better as well. And then she is 32 non-human animals. And I have to say that was what in our discussion was
to deep breathing.
Because in our old days, it was not when they were all assigned. And open the humanity also combined together, they were never separate. And science, more and more scientists and academics open up. In the world we have you now saying science not work on the world without application of humanity and compassion. If you so the bird, now, how you can set a patient care saved? They indeed, so science can save you life. But, if the person a patient,
if you OPN, so, engaging is on my agenda.
Request my chariot, get ya. The door's OPN, take that high road and have been. Open up.
You won't be BM. We should be closer than friends. If you OPN and take the high road and hop in. Open up, open up. Shut it down like a Macintosh.
Open up,
open up, open up.
glass and Coca-Cola. Open up.